啦啦。Hello, peeps, welcome back to Prison the Architect and welcome back to Le Corp Jail, where things just keep biggering and biggering and biggering. And since the last episode, we have now completed the Supermax section. It's not decorated yet, but it is all built. So really, really pleased about that. And I shall show you around in just a moment. And what else have I been up to? Oh, well, should we have a closer look? Look, look. It's that morning routine where they all get agitated. Look. Oh, no. Oh, no. So she's just going around trying to kill everybody. Can we get somebody in here, please? Yeah, these guys, they get a little bit agitated first thing in the morning. It is true. It is true. However, believe it or not, this is an improvement. and I'll tell you why in just a moment. But not only is this built and filled with Supermax ladies, but we have been around the entire prison and made sure that we have drains under all showers and toilets. We have done that throughout the jail, which is important. So although I haven't, like, in some rooms, can you see here, in some of them, and maybe I should have done this in Supermax as well, and I didn't. Maybe I should have done is that I've put the drains in the door for the simple reason that when a room is flooded, this is when I know that there is a prisoner in there, probably up to no good. And with the drains underneath the toilets, the room doesn't flood, and actually, until I see blood, I may not necessarily know that there's, from a distance, something going wrong. So, you know, there is a benefit to having it in the doorway, I think, as well as directly under the toilet. Whichever you prefer. Whichever you prefer. What else have we done? What else have we done? Oh, yes. I added, and it seems to be working, over here in our little parent section, I've added play mats to each of the rooms. And the mothers do use them. So not only do they sometimes put their babies in their cribs, obviously, it's the whole point of them being there, but I have seen mothers now putting their babies on the play mats. Here we go. Even when they're in their room. How cute is that? Oh, God, you're so cute. So that's fantastic. I thought we'd give it a whirl, and it's working. So always nice when a plan comes together. We also went around the entire prison and made sure that there are chairs at all the CCTV monitors in these little offices that are at the beginning of every cell block, which will benefit the staff needs later on, which is a huge thing that we need to work towards. In fact, we're going to do quite a lot towards staff needs in the next episode, because as we know, in the last episode I removed all the staff rooms from around the wall, and now we've only got a staff room. I think we've got one here, we've got one there, and a little one down here, and then we've got quite a big one here. And our staff exhaustion tends to now go between 30 to 60 staff members constantly exhausted, averaging around 50. It's first thing in the morning and we're at like 35. By the end of the day, we could be looking at 50 to 60 staff exhausted. So this is, you know, clearly still a lot of work to go on here. Yes, definitely. So yes, our Supermax ladies are clearly a little rambunctious this morning. Today is the first day that I have actually let out some of the legendaries. What has been going on here? Well, we've been having quite a lot of problems with the Supermax. Ladies, every morning was turning into an absolute bloodbath. This is all right in comparisons to what was happening before. I mean, as soon as they got in here, in fact, often before they even got here, there would be massive punch-ups, deaths, just bodies everywhere. It was a real nightmare, and it was like that every morning. And even something terribly tragic happened.
Thank you.
Yeah, Fairbairn. Rip Fairbairn. So, I mean, there was no other inmate like her. I loved Fairbairn. She was like the life of the party. She was going to be our test subject to see if our rehab centre was going to work. I mean, who are we going to use now? It's just so terrible. But it did cause me to take a look at some of the problems we clearly have here with these rambunctious ladies. And one of the main things that I did is in intelligence, is I have been in the process of moving everybody that basically has a tag from maximum security into supermax. So these are all of our most deadly and violent ladies here, right? However, the ones I've left over in maximum security are our instigators, so our ladies that are most likely to try and start fights and get others involved, or get more involved, aren't they? They're more likely to get others involved. And I've moved the volatile back to maximum security. So all the volatile ladies are here, and they are the ones that kick off for no reason. So if anything now, it's probably going to be these that we have massive problems with. What I have found, because it was just sort of like a test run, but I think I'm going to keep it like this. What I've found is that both areas are a little bit rowdy. And we get the odd death, like we had one this morning. But on the whole, it's much calmer. It is actually much calmer than it was. And as suspected, this canteen was nowhere near big enough for the amount of ladies that we've brought in. So we have now expanded this cafeteria for them, and we've duplicated it on the other side, ready for our protective custody section. Look, I've built the first cell block. Do you remember we started building it ages ago and then dropped it? Well, here it is. And today what we're going to do is move all the protective custody people that are stuck in here into their new cell block, and then this one can be put back as cell grading benefits. So that'd be really great. This would be more cells for these guys. So that's really exciting. We're going to do that today. And something else that we're looking at, because we've got a legendary problem, all right? So these legendary, let's just call her, because I think we've actually had some prisoners in, yes, this morning. Look at this. So immediately I want to start upping these to supermax. So we've got a snitch there. But I can't, because we've actually got some space issues. Some of you may notice that this is flashing and it's all alarmed. And yeah, there's not much I can do about it at the moment. Anyway, what was I doing? I've been sidetracked. Yes, legendaries. So we've got legendaries here. Look, extremely volatile. And this one, extremely volatile. And this one, extremely volatile. So I've taken to locking them in their cells 24/7, which is a real problem in Supermax, because these cells are not designed for such long hours of lockup. However, over in our protective custody, these cells are designed for long hours of being stuck in your room. So it could be that we're going to try something very dangerous. And we are probably going to be moving some of our legendaries into protective custody. Can you believe it? It's so dangerous. It's so stupid and reckless. But that's what we're going to do. And they'll be on permanent lockdown, but they should be a bit more appeased because they'll be in a nicer room. And we'll see how it goes, I guess. We'll see how it goes. It's worth a test. But if they get out, can you imagine the carnage? They'll just kill every single snitch and ex-law enforcement that's in there, right? yeah. So... yeah, we'll just have to see how that goes. And just to be especially dangerous, this is going to be our rehab center here. This is focused solely on rehabilitation, whether it's anger management or alcohol abuse or drug abuse, just some spirituality, anything that helps rehabilitate. We've got classrooms for education and stuff like that. What we don't have are things like workshops, and the shop, mail sorting and stuff like that. They don't have any of that here because it's unnecessary. although they can work in laundry down here. So their all their spare time or work hours need to be focused on their rehabilitation, and that's going to be true of our Supermax, but also of our protective custody, because I do something dangerous with protective custody. Not only do I put our at-risk people in here, but I also put people in here with particularly severe drug and alcohol problems. And when I say severe, I pick the prisoners that have either these little bottles here next to their name, or they have a little pill bottle next to their name. So I take these particular ladies and I plonk them into protective custody. It's mental, isn't it? And then not only do I do that, but I'm going to make these two sections share this rehabilitation centre through the means of timed gates. So they won't both be in there at the same time, because that really is stupid. But like in the morning, I think it'll be these guys, and in the afternoon it'll be these guys. So they'll filter out and they'll come in. That sort of deal. So they both get the benefits of our rehabilitation centre. Basically, this whole area here is like a fish tank. How close can you get electricity to water without killing yourself? That's what all this is about. And two deaths today, and we'll find out. I'm sure that we'll probably get a lot more deaths. Oh my god, they've killed a teacher! I think the first thing we're going to do here today is we're going to open up our bureaucracy, because we don't have a lot left and I have so much money. I think what we're going to do is we're just going to start unlocking all the remaining stuff. There's an achievement for it. There's an achieve. So we're just going to get it all unlocked now, because I had over 300 grand, look, and I've just spent a load of it, and I've still got 248,000 doubloons. So we might as well open up bureaucracy. Why muck around with it? Oh, look, and look, we've not been paying attention to intelligence. Let's see, we've got extremely volatile. So she will always stay in maximum security, which will be fabulous. But yeah, we do need to sort this out. We do need to it'll sort itself out over time. I'm sure it will. We've got a holding cell, you know. It'll be fine. So we've done the bureaucracy. The next thing we're going to do is actually start using these cells. So what do we want to do here? We are going to undo these rooms. So let's see here. We are going to, in deployment, change this to shared facilities. And now I'm hoping that they will start to move out all of our, yeah, look, they've all been put into shackles, ready to be moved. Here they come. They're going to start moving all these ladies into this new cell block over here. Which will be fantastic, because I think we are sort of spilling over a bit. Look, we've got 31 of them at the moment. And now, because I've just switched off those 30 cells, we only actually have 30 cells available. So we are, that's the first step, is to get these ladies over here and get this canteen up and running. We don't want to lock these open. No. Because they're going to be using this cell, this area here, aren't they, for their yard. Oh, in fact, yes. Should we do that? Because they're going to no longer be locked up in their rooms all this time. They have been locked up in their rooms, and we are going to finally set them free into this area. But we will need to get some patrols going, because I'm assuming that snitches might kill other snitches even. You know, are they a target for each other? Not sure. So we need to keep an eye on it. I can see a lot of carnage and death happening with sorting out this section. I certainly can. And shall we also do that? Lovely. Right, oh my god, we've had another death. What is going on? Honestly, it's not been that bad recently. Look, Instigator. She's killed two cops. She's down. Wow. We are having problems. I'm not sure why. Is it because here we've got them in work and lock up, and that they simply don't like it? Could it be that in maximum security? It could be, couldn't it? Should we look at their Should we look at their needs? Clothing is a big one, isn't it? Clothing has always been a big one. What about if we look at maximum? Oh, look. Yeah, clothing. Clothing's a real issue. So they're obviously all kicking off mainly about their clothing. Just get on with work. Has this still got jobs? Yeah, look. Maybe we need more laundry. Do you think we need more laundry rooms? Who knows? Who knows? We're keeping on it. Oh, you may have noticed as well that there's no access to this area anymore. And I've got a feeling we might not be putting snipper towers up because I am sick and tired of my cleaners coming out here and cleaning all this sand. It's got to stop. And in fact, stopping them from doing it has significantly reduced exhausted staff as well. So what is... We're having all kinds of problems today. They're rowdy throughout, aren't they? Oh my God, look at the scissors. Look at the scissors. What is going... Just calm down. 232 prisoners have complaints. Mainly about clothing, by the looks of it. Yeah, look, mainly about clothing. I mean, why is clothing not happening? I think this lock-up time might be an issue. I think the lock-up time might be an issue. We may need to look into this. If you've got a better idea for a regime, let me know. I just feel like... The thing is, you don't want too much free time. The problem with too much free time is this is when they develop bad habits like drug taking and stuff like this, which is something we don't really want. So they're down to a minimum. Because they are maximum security, their minimum free time is 3 hours without it causing sort of problems in the long run. Should I fiddle with their free time to be something... More like this? Should it be more like this? The thing is like, this is far too much free time, as far as I'm concerned. Far too much free time. I'm not sure. What do you think? What do you think, peeps? Maybe you should let me know. I like to keep the regimes reasonably similar to each other, otherwise it's just too confusing, really. Better put that back, because they've only just got out. And it does have a cooling effect. Can you see the freedom is having a cooling effect? Because they're probably able now to deal with their clothing needs. Yeah, it's going down. This needs thought. Clearly. We'll see. We'll see how that goes. They're definitely getting rowdy. Right. Oh, that distraction. Oh, that distraction. How's this going? Are we moving them over? Oh, look, they are. Look. Look at this. They're all being moved over. Isn't that fantastic? Oh, my God. Are you happy? Do you like this? Is this better? Is this good? Is this improved upon? And then, yeah, so they're slowly being moved out of here. These rooms are becoming free. Yay! Moving them over. I'm moving them over. And it means now that we have more pressure on this kitchen. I do need to keep an eye on it to see if they're able to produce the meals required over here. Yeah, definitely. It's afternoon yard time. How are you all feeling? Oh, yes. Look, I also changed this here. This is more secure now. So it means that staff can come through this wall and out into this section, slowly improving it. What is bad, though, at the moment is that there's no through route here. So this needs changing. This does need changing. Oh my God. It is scary having this many Supermax ladies. Particularly when you put it on this and you can just see all of the unpleasant tags of what they are. And a lot of these benches are facing the wrong way. Actually, these ones are right, but these are facing the wrong way. I've got a feeling these are as well. Are you going to sit down, White? Are you going to show us all? Are you going to demonstrate? No, you're not. Okay, what a bitch. What a bitch. Cox. Evelyn Cox. Not a name in the game. Whatever. I thought we'd have some fun there, but no. Apparently not. Oh, look, they're doing well. Look, they're getting food out. They are getting food out. Look, we've put another TV up here, and radiators went down because they were complaining about the cold, so we had to get lots of heating down. Indeed we did. They seem all right, don't they? So... gravel. I like there. This is... We've got these paths back here so that dogs, sniffer dogs, patrol at night time around the outside of the cell blocks for tunnels, of course. Do you know, we've never had any in Supermax. It's a bit concerning. It makes me wonder if we're just not catching them. There's definitely something here, isn't there? Some sort of tunnel. Look at all these yellow flags. Jesus, this, where is it? Where is this tunnel? Whoa. Oh, it just keeps going. Oh, look at the size of that tunnel. That's a big one. Big ones. Wow, we were. Well, it's going to be expensive to clean up, isn't it? But there is a dog for every single cell block, and they spend the nights just going around the cell blocks. So, you know, I mean, surely. Anyway, so gravel back there, but we've got our pass for our dogs, which is nice. Now, how are the pass? I think the pass are largely okay. And this door is probably going to go at some point. Oh no, what's this? A recent high-profile gang case has implicated one of our minimum security prisoners as a high-ranking gang leader. They've remained under the radar, but now everyone knows who they are. Right, that's really dangerous. So if we... Oh my god, there you are. Look, a legendary. Let's look at her. Alexis Griffin. Wow. So, let's see. Stoical, strong, tough, fearless, quick. She can just go straight up to Supermax. She doesn't need to be locked up or anything like that. She doesn't have volatile or instigator or cop killer. We don't have to worry about her. Cop killers, I tend to... I do put cop killers up to here. I think it's best that they're away from instigators and the volatile, because, you know, if the police start beating down on a cop killer, they probably will kill them. Right, what else? Now that's covered. Now look, we've got a valve pipe back here, so maybe we should put path access to it back here. And maybe we should have a gate somewhere back here. Should we make this here into a gate? Should we make that into a gate? Let's see. Can we just... Yeah, let's make that into a gate. So that gives them access back there. That'll be nice. And then, not road, but then we want gravel along here. Will they need access back here? Oh, yes, they do, because look, we've got this as well. So if we put in... this as path as well. And we'll put in another jail door there. Ooh. And then we want gravel along here. Oh, this is nice. We'll have gravel along there. This will make this all looking neat, won't it? This will look nice. This will start looking smarter. Because this area at the moment, it's a bit messy, isn't it? It's a bit messy. And for now, because I'm not quite sure what's going to happen with this section, so we'll actually put a path in there. We'll do that. Right, and then the rest of it is pretty much grass. We like to keep things crisp and clean, bright and airy. Yeah. It's important. Look, and we've got... See that? We've got... got a gateway there, but I don't think we'll worry about putting a path into it. Oh no, look what I've done. Look what I did. Did you see that? I messed it up. Totally messed it up. Oh yeah. Oh, the grass. Can never have too much grass as far as I'm concerned. Just, should we just do that? It's much easier, isn't it? And, oh! Should we get some grass in the dog area? That'd be nice. Although, I do want to get some paving in there at some point as well, but we'll just stick some grass down there for the time being. Lovely jumpies. Good. Lovely. Ah! That I'll start making this area look really, really good. And then we'll get some trees down as well. I think that'd be lovely. That'll look really, really smart. Indeed it will. Yeah. How's it going? Did we manage to get through dinner sort of reasonably okay? Look at the state of this place. It's disgusting, isn't it? Isn't it disgusting? It really is. What do I do in the kitchens? Is it white tiles? Should we go and have a look? It's just white tiles throughout. White tiles throughout. Should we do that then? White tiles throughout. And then we got the ceramic tiles in, sort of like the toilet. We had to put some toilets down. But has it made much of a difference? I mean, who knows? Who knows? Because, I mean, it's still disgusting out here. It really is. That'll do. We'll make all this ceramic tiles as well. And I think was it all this ceramic? Do you know? I wasn't sure. We'll do that. We'll do that. And look, we'll. Oh, it's all outside. It's all outside. We'll do that. Do that. Alrighty, lots of ceramic tiles. It's important. Oh, we won't do that. We won't do that. What else can we decorate? Look, all this. Because we need to do this. So, what's our laundry? Oh, look, it's wooden floors. It's wooden floors. We've already done the white tiles. And look, again, we like to do ceramic tiles here. And then, look, they actually have a nice wooden floor area. Oh, look at him. Ironing away. Did you see him? Fantastic. There we go. What about the common room then? What have we got? Oh, look. Oh, it's that mosaic stuff. I like listening to them lay the mosaic stuff. It makes such a lovely sound as it goes down. It really does. Back to ceramic floors over here. And then it's like a really ugly floor. But it's such a pretty sound as it goes down. As far as I'm concerned, that's what's important. Does this? It's not as nice. It's nowhere near as nice. What about parole then? How do the parole buildings look? Because these are just parole rooms. Actually, they've got like marble floors, haven't they? Wow, swanky. Oh, very smart. This is because I like to make, when outsiders come in, I like to put them in a nice environment that. Ooh, outsiders. Oops, can you stop? There we go. Parole. And then, oh, in solitary, I definitely like to do metal floors. In solitary. I like offices to be wooden. And then I'm assuming that mosaic, oh look. Huh? Oh, it's such a pretty sound. Pop in the arcade machine. I love that sound. Such a lovely sound. Right, okay. What were we doing? Totally sidetracked. Oh, yes. Yeah, it is mosaic. Look, oh, brilliant. More mosaic.
Yay.
I'm right down there. Like that. Lovely. What else? Oh, look. Yeah, we've got the staff area to think about. Do that. And then. Actually, do that. Isn't decorating fun? this is the same. So we need to do all of these the same. So that's ceramic. That's wood. Now we leave the cells concrete. And then we make all this is the brown mosaic. This gets ceramic as well. Look, we still got loads of money. Even though we had murders today, and so our daily flow has been messed with of income. You know, it's not a concern. So we've just got so much money. Right, so there we go. Let's repeat that along the line. There we go, repeat it all along the line. And we can start as well, I think, probably getting some trees down, couldn't we? But there's no gate back there, so we can go sort of quite nuts with the tree. There's no gate there. Lovely. We want to be mindful of that gate. And this gate here. You can do them either side like that. Better. We're going to definitely need some more lighting as well, I think, at some point around here. I generally don't like trees to be too straight. A bit more rough. Perfection's boring, in my opinion.
In my little opinion.
Right, okay. Look! And then we just watch them make it all beautiful. Like I say, we probably could do with some better lighting going down, couldn't we? We probably could do with a bit more lighting. Have we got lighting outside most of the buildings? Not all of them, most of them, look. Okay. Right. But wouldn't it be nice if we could... Actually, with a three... You could do the lighting down the middle of the path. What do we think about that idea? How many do we put? I think I normally do about seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think if I just keep doing this all the way down the line, this might make night path. Nice lit path! There we go. So we can let them get those installed slowly. Ah, look, can you see? Ah, that's going to be quite pretty, I think. So we'll be able to see where like the long paths are. It might be something that I continue in other places. Move them off the sides and bring them down the centre. I might do that at some point. Yeah. Oh, look, and it's sleepy time, so we can do a shakedown. Christ, in one day. Because last night I did a shakedown as well. And this was totally empty. And now look, in one day, this is what happened. And scissors is a real problem in this jail. I'll tell you something. Scissors is always such a high number. And look, poison's creeping up as well. We need to keep a closer eye on these cleaning cupboards. Thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed the episode. If you did, please hit that like button. As long as you are here, why not check out one of my delectable videos available? Feel free to come stalk me on social media and be sure to share this video with friends so even more may watch my chizwa. See you next time, peeps!